just like
enemies of Hinduism and traitors of Hinduism attacked me, even the so-called intellectuals of Hinduism have attacked me, especially with this one idea: Vedanta is separate, Siddhanta is separate. Paramashiva solves that problem once and for all in this one verse. वेदसारार्थकं तंत्रं तस्मत् वैदीगं आचरेत् वेदांतार्थमयं ज्ञानं सिद्धांतं परमं शुभम्. So last 27 years of my hard work is in one line, one sink. No one can question me intellectually. The spiritual authority of me and my words, what I am teaching, what I was teaching, I am teaching, I am going to teach. Last 26 years, all the scriptures related to Vedas means Upanishads. Then agamas. In agama, different agamas like kamika agama, karana agama, and agamic scriptures like Kashmira Shaivites books, Shiva sutras, Vijnana Bhairava tantra, Spandakarika, all various Vedic books and Vedantic books like Brahma Sutra, Bhagavad Gita. Agama, Kamika Agama, Karana Agama, and Agamanta, the agamic literatures like Siddhanta literatures in Kashmira Shaivism, in South Indian Saiva Siddhantam and Veera Shaivam. I have elaborately spoken, commented, revived many of the scriptures in last 26 years. Fortunately, much is recorded and available in the video record form or in audio form, multiple ways. One of the major attack I face in my life from the intellectual pundits is that Vedanta is separate, Siddhanta is separate. How can he connect everything? Understand? Paramashiva has come to my rescue, to protect me, to prove I am right through this verse. Vedasarartakam tantram tasmat vaidigam acharet vedantartamayam jnanam siddhantam paramam subham. I want all my disciples to write this verse 51 times today. I'll upload it in the Facebook. Please share this one verse with the translation, because this is the major important defense. Paramashiva himself protecting me from one of the biggest intellectual attacks done on me. Please understand. Many of my disciples may not be aware about this attack. For all of you, what I say is Vedanta, what I say is Siddhanta. So you guys don't bother much about it. But the intellectual pundits who have a lot of political influence in India, who are decision makers, they were ready to cut my head, but they are not ready to sit and talk to me. They just want to finish me off. They don't want to listen. They don't even want these Shastra references, because they are not interested in truth. They are interested more in political power. See, using Hinduism for political gains. So they don't really want to get into the spiritual depths of Hinduism.